What's going on, guys? This is Alec here, and welcome to the Swansea City Player of the Season 2016-17. As you can see, here are the nominees: Michel Vorm, Leroy Fair, Mo Barrow, Gylfi Sigurdsson, and Memphis. Let's get on to nominee number one. We've got Michel Vorm. In the background, you're just going to be seeing some highlights from each of the players that I've decided to nominate. And then at the end of the video, obviously, I'll ask you which player you think deserves the player of the season, as well as that after each player highlights I will be showing the stats that they had throughout the season, you know, how many clean sheets Vorm had and how many goals and whatnot all the players had. But yeah, five nominees. Hopefully you agreed with me. I was debating whether or not to put Baston in there, but I decided not to in the end. I would like to clarify as well that this is all I'm going to be doing as far as awards go, because it is a lot of effort trying to go through all the footage from the last bit of the season. Not the last bit of the season, sorry. Going through all the footage through the whole season and then making notes of which player did what good when. And so, like, I've spent the last couple of days trying to get the footage for this to show you guys. And I'm not going to lie, I did enjoy doing it, but it's not that, it's the fact that I've had to spend like two or three days editing each video, and therefore I'm not putting videos out as frequently as I'd want to. So next season I'll probably just do the same again. I'll probably just do the player of the year and the goal of the season. But as you can see, this is Michel Vorm's stats. He played 38 games, which is all of the games in the Premier League, and half of them were clean sheets, directly half, 19 of them were clean sheets, and he averaged a 7.10 match rating out of them all. Next one on the list, Leroy Fair. I mean, this was a bit of a debatable one because he didn't get that much goals or assists, but I thought he deserved to be in there just due to the fact that when I was playing in-game, I really, really enjoyed using him. I thought he was a cracking player. He did score some crucial goals as well. It's one of them ones that he really went, not unnoticed, but underrated, I think would be the best word. But as you can see, he played some fantastic through balls throughout the season, as well as popping in with a few goals. Obviously, he's not going to get the most goals because Sigurdsson is the attacking midfielder, and he's the one just in behind. But, you know, when he's scoring goals like that and contributing, it's nice to have in the team. But like I said, these are the only two. I think what I'll do is I'll bring another video out, and I'll show the goal of the season, which you voted, and then I'll say my player of the season, and then I'll show your guys' player of the season. So I'll make another poll in the description below. It takes 2 seconds to vote, so if you just go over there and click on the player that you think deserves the player of the year. But onto the highlights. As you can see, Leroy Fair, like I said, put in some really good through balls. Look at that, 7.8 average match rating. That is impressive, as well as getting 5 goals and 9 assists throughout the season. I mean, the clean sheets doesn't really count because it's not him, but yeah, 33 games in the Premier League, and he played a couple of cup games here and there. Number 17, Mo Barrow, a third nominee. He popped in with a surprise few goals throughout the season. A lot of them were the same, as you can see, just cutting in from the right-hand side and finessing it down into that bottom left-hand side of the goal. Really was a really, really vital player for me. I think I said in episode 1 that Mo Barrow is going to be one of the more important players for us, and I'll stick by that now. He's obviously done very well, making some nice assists for players and scoring some nice goals himself as well. He's such a threat because of the pace he's got. Like, you can see, he'll just get past defenders and go down the line. That's Van Aanholt there, who's not a slow defender, and then he'll just torment defenders. He comes inside and he actually wins the penalty there. Like, I mean, he does stuff on his own at times, but as you can see, he'll just come inside and a lovely through ball for Sigurdsson there. Again, in the same game against West Ham, he scores a lovely goal. He's such a nice player to have in your team. I like Nathan Dyer down on that right hand side, but I mean, I just don't think he quite compares to Mo Barrow in terms of what he brings to the team. Mo Barrow's such a direct player. He likes squaring players up, getting past them, and either, you know, putting it, like, as you can see, he gets past the defender and puts a lovely through ball there for Baston, who I think actually missed that chance in that game. But if he's not providing for someone, he'll get through on goal on his own, and he'll shoot and he'll score. That's just what he does. But there's Mo Barrow. Really enjoyed him this season, and I think he's definitely a shout up there. Considering his age as well, it's impressive. 24 years old, and in the 36 games he played, let's say, he got 10 goals and 10 assists with an average rating of 7.6 in the Premier League. Only missing 2 Premier League games out there, which is quite good for a 24-year-old. Gylfi Sigurdsson, the next player on the list, as you can see, his first highlight here just scores a free kick. I that one wasn't the best one. Well, to be fair, I think I scored 3 free kicks with him this season, and none of them were particularly special. I think that was probably the best of the bunch. But as you can see here, this play I liked so much. It didn't get a goal from it from the end, but it was a lovely bit of skill to get past the defender, and he put a lovely ball in at the back post. Lovely goal there, chipping it over the keeper. I mean, Sigurdsson did this time and time again, just getting through one-on-one with the keeper, and he's so clinical, as he proves there from outside the box. He's definitely one of my favourite players to use. I said at the start of the series that I think Mo Barrow is going to be the most important, but you know, definitely Gylfi Sigurdsson has proved that he's definitely up there. But I mean, goals and assists are one thing, and look at that assist there. But you know, overall performance as well has got to be taken into account. But I don't think you can look past the amount of goals and assists that Siggy got this season. I mean, I know he is in behind the striker, and that's what he's meant to be doing, is scoring goals and getting assists. But when he's doing stuff like that, I mean, it's hard to look past him for a player of the season. But I'd be interested to know what you guys think. I mean, as you can see here, I think this was one of the last game of the season, actually, and he'd been out for a couple of games. But look at that, 17 goals and 16 assists with an average rating of 8.4. That is impressive. He only missed 2 games throughout the whole season. That was due to injury, and I think in them 2 games we didn't create or score any goals. They were both nil-nilers, and then as soon as he comes back in that West Brom game, I think he got two assists. So it showed how important he was. But Memphis, the last player on the list, I don't know whether you guys would be surprised. I don't think you will be. He had a fantastic season for us. Lovely goal there past Watford. It was definitely, I think Baston would have been the other person that deserved a shout, but I've decided to go with the players that I've gone for. As you can see here, Memphis scoring. Well, I think I could probably actually I'm not going to confirm it. Well, I think you can see yourself who wins the goal of the season, but I think this is leading the goal of the season for right now. The lovely, lovely solo goal from Memphis. Lovely chip over the goalkeeper. As you can see here, him, similar to Barrow, he just scored a lot of goals cutting in from that left-hand side onto his right foot and scoring some crackers. He's obviously more known, I'd say, for getting the long shots and stuff than Barrow is, but which I did try throughout the season. But yeah, there's Memphis. I didn't get as much highlights. I noticed that a lot of his goals were tap-ins and stuff, but as you can see here, 12 goals and 6 assists in 34 games in the Premier League. He also got a goal and assist in the EFL Cup, but that's 7.6 average match rating. Please leave me know, well, say in the comments who you voted for, and go on the Twitter poll, not the Twitter poll, just go on the poll, leave a vote. It literally takes 2 seconds. Thank you all for watching, and I'll bring the awards video out soon. Peace.